Sabir, MLA for Calgary McCall, and I'm joined here by my colleague from Calgary Buffalo this riding, MLA Joe Ceci. I would also like to recognize my colleague from the Legislature Minister of Multiculturalism, Leela Fahir. So, organizers asked us to reflect on what the previous speakers have said. I think it's a daunting task, but I will try my best to summarize what I heard and plan what I can do going forward. First and foremost, we are talking here about racism, so let me begin by respectfully acknowledging the land we are gathered on, that it belongs to TD7 people, and it's also home to Métis people of Alberta who have endured injustices, racism, and we have a past to reconcile with, and we have to end that racism as well. Second thing, people here who were speaking, they come from many different backgrounds, many different cultural backgrounds, ethnic backgrounds, but I think one thing was clear, that they were all united against racism. So let me begin by condemning the rise of racism, incidents that have happened in last little while. So I condemn that on behalf of my colleague, my leader, Richard Nanti, and we condemn these incidents, and we stand with the victims, and we pledge to do everything in our power that we can to put an end to these such violence and incidents of hatred and racism. I think I can say that I heard things on three different lines. First and foremost, we need to demand better from ourselves. Every one of us have some biases, prejudices, so we need to be self-aware. We need to think about what we can improve in ourselves. That's where I think we should be starting. And when we see incidents of racism, when we see people getting victimized, I think it's every one of us' obligation to stand up against racism, to stand not as bystanders, but actively anti-racist on the side of those who are on the receiving end of racism. Second thing, we need to demand better from our families, from our friends, from our institutions, from police, from our schools, from our universities. We need to demand better when it comes to racism.
Yeah.
And the third thing is, we need to demand better from our governments as well. And there are many things that I heard today. First, there is a motion before the Alberta legislature urging this government to denounce the use of hateful and racist symbols like tiki torches in the broad daylight in the streets of Calgary, and urging this government to outlaw these symbols in public spaces. So that's what I heard, and that's what we are doing in the legislature, and in coming days, we will be asking this government to ban these hateful symbols in Alberta streets and public spaces.
Yeah.
Second thing, I think regardless what side of the aisle my colleague and I sit on, racism is not a partisan issue. We are asking this government to put together a committee, a bipartisan committee, with people from different political sides to work on the solution, to work on legislation that can address racism in our province.
Yeah. War room against racism.
There is absolutely no room against racism in our province.
Yes.
What are you going to do, UCP?
And other thing is, other thing is that we have seen human rights and multiculturalism grant cut in last 2 years. Right now, in our budget, there is $0 for human rights and multiculturalism grant that used to be quite a bit of money. Work on initiatives, protecting human rights, and fighting against racism. We are asking this government to put money where their mouth is, restore those grants, and fund those initiatives to address human rights abuses, to address race incidents of racism. Yeah. Other thing is, when it comes to federal government, there was a speaker said that hate crime legislation need to be made more effective. Last week, when that incident happened here in Princess Albert Island Park, the Calgary police issued a statement as well. And they said that their enforcement is limited by the legislation around hate crime. And I agree with Calgary police. And we call on the federal government as well to amend that legislation, give the Calgary police the tools they need so they can fight along with our community, racism in our cities, racism in our province, because it's a crime against the basic human dignity and it has no place in our province, in our country, in our society. Thank you so much.